Duha, pusto most ma vibrebine. I daj mi ne to osuđuvate zgratamo. Duha, pusto most ma. Коли ми говоримо пусто, які прия гріх, то ми проти брати нашого брата і сестри. А коли ми проти них, ми проти самого Ісуса Христа. Бо вони є ікони, так як ти, вони є іконами. І так як ми шануємо ікону, ми шануємо все, що коло нас. І що ми про них говоримо? Є просте слово. Чи ми, Боже, не радіємо говорити з зеркалі? Чи ми не радіємо осуджувати брата і сестру? Ми ще маємо бути вірні. Так що вам звертаються. Дійсно є початок добрий. Латвій новий початок починається такою молитвою і такою поведінкою. А втім, звичайно, на наша філософія. Менше говорити про друге. Якщо ж Слово Боже, нехай будемо ми дивиналистами. Говорим добро про них. Дивимося на нашого ближнього, на сусіда, так як Бог дивиться на них. Дивимося на них, так як Бог дивиться на нас. І таким способом гідно ми будемо ходити з Богом Богом. Не усуджувати. Бо ми маємо свої проблеми. Якщо ми не будемо розподівати, то ми не будемо почувати. Щастиво може, це 5 тижнів ва, це великого пору. Вважаємо за ту молитву, цей час, і вважаємо за розчуючення. Згодний Бог. Подію проти за сити. Today's word is icon. It's the Greek word for image. Icon, image. We read it first in the scripture this week when we're reading Genesis. We hear that God created Adam and Eve. He created us in His own image and likeness. We are the icon of our Creator. We are the icon of Christ. When we are baptized, we accept His image as our image. And so if you need baptized into Christ, you should see Christ and see how far I've fallen. Now that. Elias, and I see you as the same. Do I see Jesus in your person? If I do, how blessed I am. We are created in the image and likeness of God. That's why when our Jesus goes around, he intends the holy images. We just said. And then he turns and he intends you. Why? Because you are also holy image. You are the image of your creator, Jesus Christ. And then take it to the next step. Well, if we want to know the Father, who is God the Father, what's He like? Look at His Son, Jesus. Jesus is the image of the Father, the perfect likeness. In today's prayer, St. Basil, later on, I hope that you can hear it back there. You'll hear that He is, Jesus is the perfect image of the Father. So if you want to know what God the Father is like, we know. Look at Jesus. Read about Him. Meditate upon Him. Welcome him into your life. And you'll see what God the Father is like through His Son. It is our challenge to become the image and likeness of our Lord Jesus Christ. That when people see you, they see me, they see an icon of God. Someday, this church. Very soon, actually. We're already planning to have the images, the icons replaced in this church. We already have the images being planned for the iconostasis. They're placed before us in order to remind us of the fact that God is not somewhere far away. They are here to remind us that God is among us. Constant reminders. Icons are not decorations. Icons are not wall painting, it's just to kind of make the church beautiful. Icons are to remind us that God is present among us. That God is not here somewhere away on Mount Olympus somewhere. He is here among us. And that's why on this particular Sunday, it's the Sunday of Orthodoxy, the Sunday of the restoration of icons. In the 9th century, the church in her wisdom, blessed by God, restored icons to the worship in the churches. What a joy it is for us to know that we are part of the picture, whether up in heaven, before the throne of God, at the end of time, where the angels and the saints and the altars and the vessels and the incense and the hymns are all taking place, or whether already here it is taking place. The image of God is already present in you and me, and the image of the worship of God is already present here in this holy place. And the complete picture is made possible by our being surrounded by the icons. Lord Jesus Christ, you love us so much, but you've given us your teaching, surrounded us in such a beautiful manner, in color, in the birth of our brothers and sisters, in the beauty of this worship. You love us so much that you've given us this morning's worship, a taste of what has become of all eternity. To you, who give us the icon, the image of the heaven which is and is to come, to you, glory and honor, for ages and ages. Amen.